Welcome.
House Speaker John Boehner planning to sue the president over alleged abuse of executive power. Speaker Boehner saying he will not tolerate him taking power away from Congress.
I believe the president is not faithfully executing the laws of our country. And on behalf of the institution and our Constitution, standing up and fighting for this is in the best long-term interest of the Congress.
Jonah Goldberg now, editor-in-chief of National Review Online. How are you, sir, and good morning to you. Did you see Bachman and Cavuto yesterday? Oh, my gosh. I mean, just take a sample of this here, real quick.
What we need to do is defund the executive branch, number one, and then impeach
defund, wait, think about what you're saying. Defund the executive branch.
If Congresswoman,
if Democrats had said, we're going to defund President Bush, we're going to defund the executive, you would laugh them out. And so you should have then. And I think Democrats would be in their right mind to laugh you out now. Defund them.
Listen, the House has the power of the purse. This isn't a small power. We can do this, but we can do something further. I hear your frustration.
All right,
what we can do further is impeach the elected officials that have broken the law.
Rome's burning, and you're filing.
All right, so now, what Cavuto's arguing is that it goes nowhere. Don't waste your time on it. What Boehner and Congresswoman Bachman are arguing is that you cannot allow the president to continue to do what he's doing with changes on Obamacare, the EPA, et cetera. Where are you on this, Jonah?
I'm sort of in the middle of a lot of this. First of all, I think that we should have given Cavuto and Bachman some giant Nerf bats to duke it out. That would have been kind of fun.
That's nice.
Look, I agree entirely with Speaker Boehner's underlying complaint about the unilateralism, excess of power, all the stuff that Obama has done in rewriting laws, which he is not constitutionally empowered to do. But I think the idea of, as Boehner says, we need to reassert congressional power, and then he says we're going to go whining to the courts to restore congressional power. That's not how it works under our system. The way you assert or protect congressional power is by asserting congressional power. And I think Michelle Bachman has a point, is that if the executive branch goes too far, what Congress needs to do is smartly pick its battles and defund some aspect of the government and say, hey, look, if the EPA is going to overstretch and do things that we didn't authorize, we're going to pull funding from the EPA.
Or you can look at Obamacare and the 35 different changes that have been made, too, since it was passed in the law. Jonathan Turley, you know him well. He's a constitutional professor. Here's how he categorized the certain power grab that he sees on behalf of the White House. Watch.
The president is now asserting a level of unilateral authority that dwarfs most of, if not all, of his predecessors. He is creating what I've called an Uber presidency.
An Uber presidency.
I don't have an app for the Uber presidency quite yet, but I think that'd be kind of, I guess it's a different Uber. I agree a lot with what Jonathan Turley has to say about how Obama has gone overboard. And, the defenses you hear from the White House is that he hasn't issued that many executive orders. Well, that's true. He's issued comparatively few executive orders, but the quality of the executive orders has been really incredibly broad. I mean, you can issue an executive order to say it's cupcake day in the rec hall, in the, the dining hall, and you can give an executive order saying we're going to rewrite, American health care unilaterally. They're very different things. But at the same time, first of all, this hasn't happened.
Turley said this dwarfs most, if not all, of his predecessors.
Well, I think you can make a case for that. Truman seizing the steel mills was pretty big, too, and the Supreme Court rebuffed him on that. Mm. So far, the Supreme Court hasn't rebuffed Obama significantly on a lot of these things, and I think there's still going to be lawsuits to come. But at the end of the day, there's a reason why this hasn't happened for 240 years, is that Congress normally asserts its power by asserting its own power, not by going and asking a court to protect it.
And we'll see where it goes. Thank you, Jonah. Good to see you. Jonah Goldberg there in Washington. Martha.